Welcome to Focus on Funds, the Investment Company Institute's weekly roundup of industry news, ICI activities, and research findings. ICI has released its latest research on closed-end funds, including new information on fund flows and on the investors in these funds. I spoke with ICI senior economist Shelly Antoniewicz about the paper's findings.
We try to look at some long-term trends, and one of the things that we saw is that equity closed-end funds are a growing share and have been a growing share of the closed-end fund market. So at the end of 2013, they were about 40% of closed-end fund assets, and that's up from about 25% a decade ago. Now, still, bond funds are the majority of closed-end fund assets.
Can we also touch on what's new in this paper? In addition to tracking some things that people look to from year to year, there's some new information.
We changed our survey up, and we have collected some new information, particularly on different types of preferred share classes that are out there. We got more information on different types of the preferred share classes. We also collected information on different types of leverage. So there's structural leverage and portfolio leverage. And we found that about two-thirds of closed-end funds are using some type of leverage. Now, that said, closed-end funds still have very strict limits on the amount of leverage that they can have in their portfolio because they are a 40 Act registered product. And so the average for funds that are using structural leverage, they have about a 27% leverage ratio. So still very, very low compared to other non-40 Act funds that use leverage. Closed-end fund investors tend to be older individuals that are retired from their lifetime occupation. They also tend to be a little bit more affluent than your typical mutual fund shareholder or even your typical directly held equity shareholder.
That's this week in funds. See you next week.